Let's use Xbox controller in Enscape environment. I'm Javad and we are here with a different video. Don't need it anymore. Oh, I forgot to open the box and have the joystick with myself. That was a joke. We have a Xbox controller here and we want to learn how to activate this controller in Enscape environment. It will give a fun experience to your client or even for you for controlling your project in Enscape. And personally, I love it because it will give a more rich experience to myself in comparison with the mouse and keyboard for checking my project. Let's go and let's see how we can do it. After connecting your controller with a dongle or with Bluetooth or even with a mini USB cable, you are good to go and you just need to activate the Enscape render on your CAD software or on your BIM software. It doesn't matter. It will support all of them. And then we have all of the controls that we have in with mouse and keyboard. The basics are, for example, with the left axis, you can move around, you can go forward and you can go backward and left and right. And to move faster, you need to press it and go back or go forward and backward and left and right. With pressing it, you will it will do the same thing that shift button will do. And with the D-pad, we can go and switch between different views that we made on our Enscape. It is really easy to switch between your views and you can see it in here. And with the right axis, you can look around and you can control the way that you look around with this axis. And then after going backward, forward, and looking around to your project, you have something to do. With the RT and with LT buttons, you can go down and you can go up. It will do the same thing as E and Q in keyboard. And then we have RB and LB. With these buttons, you can control the time of the night and day. And this is really great. For example, let me press RB and you can see the change in the time very easily. And with the LB, you can go backward. And that's great, guys. I love it. And then we have Y and B. With Y and B, with Y, you can immediately change your time to noon. And then with B button, you can immediately change your time to night. It will be a great way to switch between night and day very fast and efficient. And then we have A button, which is one of the most important buttons, and that's the switch between walk and fly mode. With walk mode, for example, you can go walk on a stairs and you will have collision and all of those things. And then again with pressing A, you can switch between these two. And then we don't have any other option, but in VR we have this button in here for recenter, which will move you to the recent location that you had. And with this button here, we can show and hide the instruction, and you can see all of the instruction there. But what is my thought on it? I think it is really great and it will gamify the process, and you can give a rich experience to your client instead of just putting mouse and keyboard in front of them, or in case if you don't have any VR headsets, it will be a much cheaper device to give your client a better experience. And also, as I said, if you're a gamer, you will have one of these and you can use it in your work too, but make sure to be careful and don't play games with it. Just play it in Enscape. This was the video, and if it has been helpful for you, please don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you want to know more tips and tricks about Enscape, I will put a link and I will put a playlist in here. Go on, go there and watch all of the Enscape tutorials we have on this channel. I will see you on the next session.